you've seen some of the various loading data options that are available to you. In this video, we're going to take a look at one example for using bulk insert to load data from Azure Blob Storage. So we're back in Azure Data Studio, and you can see this time I'm using a SQL notebook, and I'm just connecting to my logical database server, as well as the specific AdventureWorks database. Now, what I'm going to do is just walk through the various steps that are required to doing a bulk insert from Azure Blob Storage. Now, many of these things should be relatively familiar to you in T-SQL. It's just slightly different as we authenticate and get data from Azure Blob Storage. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a table. It's going to be hard to put data anywhere if there isn't a table for it to go. The next thing I'm going to do is create a master key, and this is going to allow me to create a database scoped credential. And this is just going to depend on how you've configured your Azure Blob Storage for access. Now, what I'm doing here is I'm creating that database scoped credential, and there are a few things to, you know, be aware of that you don't get tripped on. So, for example, there's this thing called a shared access signature. And you can generate this using various methods, but one is using Azure Data Explorer or the Azure portal. And basically, you generate this from your Azure Blob Storage so that you can, or in this case, we can connect to that data and actually pull it down. Now, one of the gotchas is that you want to make sure you remove the question mark that is present at the secret, at really all of these secrets. So just make sure you remove that. Now, the next step that I'm going to do is I'm going to create an external data source. Now, if you've worked with SQL Server 2019 or seen some of the Poly-based demonstrations, this is kind of similar to what we're doing there. So we're going to create an external data source called dataset, and we're going to specify the type as blob storage, and we're going to reference the location of where that data is and the credential which we created in the previous step. Finally, we're ready to do our bulk insert. So I'm going to kick this off, and it takes about a minute to run. So I'm going to talk to you about a few of the tips that I've added in comments of this section. One tip is setting no count on. This is going to help with network traffic slightly by stopping that message that basically shows the number of rows affected. The next thing that I'm going to do, you see I just added some comments of how this is working. So our data set is using the external data source that we created in step 4. And we're just specifying some of the details. Now, batch size is another interesting one, which Bob mentioned in the previous video. And this is going to help us reduce network traffic by inserting in batches. And really, when we're talking about sending data over the wire and just applications in general, if you can not create chatty applications, that's going to be better for your network performance and network latency that you see when you do things like this or other operations. Now, the other thing I did here is I used tablock, which helps me minimize the number of log records that are going to happen during this insert operation. Now that it's completed, I can go ahead and take a look at how many rows we inserted from that file. About almost 3 million rows. So now you've seen a simple example of how you can basically walk through creating a credential to Azure Blob Storage and bulk inserting data from a single file in Azure Blob Storage. Tune in for the next video.